And here we go. Round one scheduled for 12. And out strong, quick is Lawson.
You see Bizier walk right out, put both hands up, and sink a nice left hook into the body. His intent is very clear in this fight, Kenny. He wants to stay close to Lawson.
And Bizier is very strong, and he wants to use that power. You notice he goes to the body. But the thing about it, he walks straight in. You can't just do that. Use that jab. At least use that jab to come in, to step in, I should say.
Watching his fights, even with this style, he has never been knocked down in his pro career. He comes right at them. He takes some punishment. Does Bizier.
I like that double left hook he's using early, Ken. You see him shooting it to the head first, picking up the hand of Lawson, then sinking it to the body. It's a couple nice counter rights, though, by Lawson as well on the inside, but very selective and good sharp punching by Bizier.
Very nice and sharp punches by Bizier, especially to the head and then to the body, like that. Good shot. That's a surprising shot with the left hook, to the head and then to the body. Because most guys go from the body to the head.
And this could prove dangerous. You know, he's coming out against a guy who's 24-0 with 20 knockouts, a high, very high knockout percentage, coming right out and standing in the trenches with him. So important that Bizier keeps his head off the center while he's walking in. Lawson's a very strong puncher.
Bizier is staying right there. Lawson now trying to get in his groove.
Nice left hook by Bizier. And we saw the scar tissue in the eye in the fighter meetings, Kenny, and now this style of fighting really explains why Bizier likes to get down to business.
Well, Bizier talked about he gets cut a lot, but he hasn't been stopped. He keeps going. Both his losses have been by way of split decision.
He stays in shape, Bizier. It's like the old, he looks like the old type fighters. Just walk you down and blow you away, blow you out of the ring.
But it's interesting to me, Ray, he's not a huge puncher. You know, he's a physically strong guy, but he's not a huge puncher. But he shoots very selective combinations, out then in, up then over, and he's getting good investment from his combination on the inside. But still, he's taking some from Lawson as well.
But BJ, look at those shots. I mean, he throws double hands to the body and then up to the head.
It's nice. There's no question it's nice combination punching from Bizier, but I still think he's got to be a little careful with that 24-0, 20 knockout Lawson in this first and second round.
Four of the knockouts for Lawson have come in the first. Doesn't appear he's going to get number five as we approach the 10-second mark.
He caught B. Lawson with a good left hook and hurt him at the end of the round, Kenny.
Yes, he did. He did. Seconds ticking down. What a good round one. Kevin Bizier in his U.S. debut. Mark Ramsey, his trainer, well known. Talk about a matchup of outstanding trainers. Ramsey in the Bizier corner. And Fredrick Lawson with Abel Sanchez in his corner.
Don't punch and let him answer. You work, right? Now, if you step back, a double jab is good, then you go back to work. Don't let him come at you.
You heard him. Don't let him come at you. That's the way Bizier fights, though. He comes right at him.
He sure does. And some of the work here by Lawson. You see a nice short right uppercut by Lawson on the inside. Another good jab. Good shots from Lawson. And then later in the round, a nice left hook by Bizier actually hurt Lawson against the ropes there and stood him straight up for a second round.
Had him in trouble for a bit.
There you look at Lawson. He got the name The General, even though he has some ring generalship, you can see. But he got it because he was so meticulous about his regiment that he got that nickname when he was a kid. They called him the Little General back then. That he did everything in a very orderly fashion as round two starts. And Bizier in the blue once again comes right at Lawson. That first round scored in favor of Bizier by Jake Donovan, our unofficial score tonight.
Yeah, I agree. He was the busier guy, and he landed a big left hook at the end of the round. Another one right there, Rick.
I love it. In fact, Bizier, he's more confident because he was able to put his man in a little trouble, Lawson in a little trouble at the very end of the round.
What's making that left hook effective, Ray, is he's shooting the double left hook. He's shooting the one in the body and then the head, body. So Lawson's got to watch out for both hooks. So when Bizier comes up top, he's not sure which way to block.
Very confusing. I tell fighters all the time to mix their punches up, the combinations.
But especially since Bizier doesn't cock the punch, he's right there, and he's set, and he'll shoot it to the head, then the body, and then he'll come down and shoot it to the head. And it's Lawson needs to pick up his right hand, or he needs to get under that punch with a weave.
I think what Lawson needs to do is stay in the middle of the ring. He can't get against those ropes, because that's when Bizier really takes advantage of it.
Or at least he's got to make Bizier pay whenever he's walking in like that, not shooting any punches with his hands up.
Let's check in with Todd Harris.
Mark, that first round, Kevin really set the tone. Is that something you wanted him to do, get right in front of Lawson?
Yes, we want the fight inside, put pressure on the kid, and make sure that one point in the fight, we're going to broke his tempo and make sure that Kevin put pressure on him right away.
Did you see anything in that first round that says Kevin can definitely take this guy?
Yes, but he's a good opponent. Like, we have to work properly to a stop, for a stoppage, but this is something that Kevin Bizier can do.
Thank you, Mark.
And that's the way that Bizier fights. He told us that yesterday. He said he plans on doing that today against the opponent that is younger than him, and that's what he's been doing so far.
If Bizier can keep this up, this perpetual motion, this has a tendency to wear your opponents down, because it's just an accumulation of blows, especially with the body.
And this isn't the MO for Lawson. Lawson comes forward. Lawson falls forward with his punch. It's very hard for a fighter who comes forward to fight off his back foot, and that's what Lawson's going to have to do if he wants to win tonight, because Bizier is very aggressive.
And for the power that Lawson has, you thought coming into this would shape up well for him, that Bizier is going to be a target right in front of him all night.
That's right, but Lawson's the type of fighter where he needs to extend his punches. He's not as good on the inside, so Bizier is able to smother a lot of those long punches from Lawson and take advantage.
Just like there, Bizier keeps moving right in on him, Ray.
Well, this is a pretty fast pace, pretty fast tempo.
A lot of punches thrown by these welterweights here, particularly Bizier. Lawson fighting back here as round two is coming to an end. And you look at Fredrick Lawson. From Ghana, now living in Chicago, and here he was in the Philippines 2 years ago training with Manny Pacquiao. That was before Pacquiao was getting ready to fight Brandon Rios, and he talked to us yesterday about all he learned. He said that was the first world-class champ he had been around in, Pacquiao, back in 2013. They did road work together. They sparred together. He said it was a great learning experience. As we take a look at some of the action from that last round.
And you see Lawson trying to counter Bizier with the right uppercut. Bizier coming back with another left hook, and both fighters landed good shots in that last round, but I see the effectiveness of Bizier and the aggression is taking control.
Bizier's putting a lot of pressure. He's putting a lot of pressure here.
And Bizier's doing what he's done throughout this fight. He comes right at him and gets right in front of him and pushes the action back in the face of Lawson.
But that's what you do to a fighter who's 24-0 with 20 knockouts. You like to fight coming forward? I'm going to make you go backwards, and Bizier's had a lot of success with it.
And that round going to Bizier unofficially.
And Lawson's not effective, like BJ said. In fact, he should be more aggressive and off the ropes, by the way.
I think he just needs to keep his feet moving, Ray, and plant and shoot punches, not wait for Bizier to get inside. He needs to touch him when he's trying to come inside and discourage him a little bit, because Bizier's head's right in the center. And, you know, both trainers are 1-1 against each other, you know. David Lemieux, trained by Mark Ramsey, was defeated by Golovkin, who was trained by Abel Sanchez. And also Arthur Beterbiev, who's trained by Ramsey, and Jeff Page. They're 1-1, and they're trying to break the tie right now, and both fighters are fighting accordingly.
Yeah, this has been just in the last few weeks. Their rivalry has heated up once again. Both men laughing about it and excited about both the prospects they have here in Bizier and Lawson.
But you see the temperament of Lawson. You know, he's been roughed up a little bit in these first two rounds, but he's still looking to land shots, looking to counter. And, you know, a lot of great history from fighters from Ghana. You know, Azuma Nelson, Ike Corte, and a lot of great fighters that have come out of that country. So you see some of that same temperament in Lawson. Not comparing him to those guys, but you just see the same type of demeanor.
I get what you're saying, BJ. In fact, Lawson he seems a little bit more relaxed, too. His punches are a lot cleaner. His combinations are nice.
And Bizier still doing some really good work, but you see Lawson, he's not throwing the towel in just yet, guys, and he's still looking for opportunities to land big shots against Bizier.
Well, as Lawson was telling us, and we showed the pictures of when he was with Manny Pacquiao, Also talks about what it's like to be around Gennady Golovkin in the Sanchez camp and the things he's learned just by observing the overall attitude and composure and the way that champions conduct themselves.
I love that, that left hook to the body and right hand. I mean, it's a beautiful shot by Bizier.
Bizier just landed a nice left hook to the body and a straight right hand. But, you know, going back to some of the great heritage of the fighters from Ghana, Azuma Nelson, the professor, had 19 title defenses. Beat the great Wilfredo Gomez from Puerto Rico and, you know, held that title for a long, long time. And, you know, one of the great fighters from Ghana.
And Bizier is continuing to stand right in front of Fredrick Lawson. As the final seconds of round three tick down, Lawson showing more composure in this round. But again, Bizier is right there. Wednesday night rivalry night, Canadians Penguins coverage begins 7 Eastern on NBCSN. And on Black Friday, don't miss one of hockey's best rivalries, the 2015 Discover NHL Thanksgiving Showdown. Rangers take on the Bruins on NBC. And back here in Miami, you see the corner of Kevin Bizier. And you take a look at the action here earlier against Fredrick Lawson.
A beautiful right hook to the body, then coming back with a left hook on the right hand. Kenny, that's been a very effective punch from him. He's been very effective attacking the body, lowered the hands of Lawson, and finished up top.
And Bizier, I tell you, he's not throwing one punch to the body. He's throwing double shots to the body and following with a left hook to the head.
Ray, we always talk about combination punching and how we wish the fighters would do it. Well, it looks like Bizier is taking a page out of that manual because he's really come to shoot combinations tonight.
I like what I see in him.
Let's check in with Todd Harris.
Kenny, with legendary trainer Abel Sanchez. Abel, working with Fredrick, what do you need to see more from him to be successful in this fight?
I want him to commit to his punches a little bit more. He's pulling back with some of his right hands, and he's not really giving me everything with him. Also, I don't like for him to let this man work so much. He's allowing him to throw 4 or 5 punches and not counter him back. So it's a process. He got a tough guy in front of us, so it's a process. Hopefully, Freddie will get it going.
Is Fredrick thrown off at all by the unorthodox style of Bizier just continuing to come forward?
You know what? He's a tough guy. I mean, you're going to have to fight guys like this. Freddie has had 3 previous 12-round fights, so it's not like he's not accustomed to going rounds, but he just needs to be a little busier at times in there.
Thank you, Abel. Kenny?
All right. Thanks, Todd. He said it came here as Fredrick from Ghana and Chicago around the fighters. They've been calling him Freddie. He says it sounds more like a fighter. He said he's good with that, Freddie Lawson. What he's hoping to get good with right now is to solve this situation that he's put in by Bizier standing in front of him and pressing him.
Abel Sanchez talks about him shooting, pulling back off that right hand. There's a reason, because Bizier is pushing him back and he's making it uncomfortable. Lawson's feet aren't in proper position to shoot the right hand with proper fundamentals.
And Bizier is the type of fighter that fans love because it's action. He's all, you know fully well, whatever fight he gets into, it's going to be a lot of action for as long as it lasts.
Array, he's one of those guys that really gets the most out of his ability. You know, he's not a flashy guy. He doesn't jump around and bedazzle you with speed, but he gets right in your grill and digs that body, and he makes you fight for 3 minutes every round.
Exactly, BJ. And what you see is what you get, and he puts it all together. It works for him.
A lot of guys have gone on to world championships with a consistent effort, digging the body, finishing up top, doing it every round, doing it for 12 rounds, doing it day after day, month after month. And I'm not saying Bizier is going to be a world champion, but he shows that type of temperament.
Well, Bizier, going back, he was a 7-time national champion Canada back in 06. He fought some impressive fighters, including one Felix Diaz that he was able to beat as an amateur rank.
It just really shows the temperament of this kid. He didn't just pick up boxing last week or last month. He's been doing it his whole life, and he's been beating top guys for his entire life. So, you know, with Mark Ramsey in his corner, he really didn't expect to come in this ring and do anything different tonight, Rick.
Final seconds of round 4. And picking up the pace is Fredrick Lawson as the seconds tick down. And remember, coming up, premier boxing champs coming your way, including it will be Charlo making his first title defense on NBC on the 28th and in prime time on the 12th. Figueroa, DeMarco, former champs battling out Brazil. We've seen the big heavyweight in action earlier in Birmingham. We'll see him again prime time December 12th on NBC.
Kenny, I cannot wait for that card with Brazil and Martin. You got an Olympian versus another up-and-coming guy, Charles Martin. It's going to be a great night of heavyweight action. Also, Arthur Spilka, Travis Kaufman, Chris Areola, all in that same card. I can't wait.
Great fight right now as we go into round five here live in the Miami area. Bizier in the blue and red and coming right at Fredrick Lawson as he has throughout this fight.
Nice short right hand. It actually
good hand him. By Lawson. It appears Bizier, and Lawson is shaken up a bit.
Bizier, I tell you, it's just muscle memory. The same shot.
Bizier knocks him back against the ropes. Bizier lands a stunning right on Lawson.
Six, seven.
And Kenny Lawson was hurt from that right hand, that short right hand that got him by the corner. Let's see what Bizier did, if he digs the body here.
Lawson never knocked down. That time it is a knockdown. Bizier showing more power, perhaps, than Lawson thought he had. Steve Smoger, Hall of Fame referee with us. Was that a good call? Was that a knockdown?
Excellent. Excellent call. Helplessly draped. Only the ropes held him up. Sammy did a hell of a job.
Doing a good job recovering at the moment is Lawson as Bizier comes right back at him.
You got to be here to appreciate the body shots by Bizier. I mean, it's amazing, his shots. He punches with conviction, too.
And we said tonight, Ray, we were going to learn a lot about Lawson.
Look at the shot.
You know, he's hurt again with that
Lawson
right hand again.
Lawson is wobbling. Lawson felt that one as well. Bizier has knocked him down once in this round.
And tonight, Kenny, has been a battle of attrition. Bizier said, you know what, I'm not going to get you out of there in that first or second round, but I'm going to break you down with consistent body shots, and I'm going to get you out of there one way or another.
You said the right word, break you down. That's the right phrase.
And he's doing it here in the fifth round.
And he's doing it his way. He's not fighting Lawson's fight. He made Lawson fight his fight, and, you know, he's now going to reap the rewards here.
I mean, Lawson's very durable. I mean, he's taking some pretty big shots. And it comes back with some stuff of his own.
And it's nice to see Bizier, 24-2, Lawson, 24-0. Both guys have good records. Hey, the guy has two losses. You know, Lawson's for sure going to win, right? Wrong. They still got to go in and fight the fight. And Bizier came in with an excellent strategy tonight.
And what's going to put Lawson down is a combination. He takes a pretty good shot. It's not a one shot that's going to drop him.
But, Ray, one thing you got to remember, too, is Lawson's not the same fighter now that he was in the first round because he's taken a lot of punishment already in this fifth round.
Kind of worn down.
Absolutely. He's not the same guy, the Lawson that came out of that corner in the first round.
He's no more for his power is Lawson. Bizier with 16 knockouts of his own and showing power here. It's Kevin Bizier in his U.S. debut with the knockdown of Lawson, looking strong.
And we take a good look at the intelligence of Bizier. He continually landed that left hook to the body, left hook to the head. He snuck in the right behind the guard, Ray, and really caught Lawson right on the chin, affected him with that shot. And Lawson simply didn't expect it. He was looking for something on the right side from the left hook of Bizier.
Just great work by Bizier. Punches together, you have his man in trouble, and he takes advantage of it.
Intelligent, you see the amateur pedigree. He's thinking in there, digging both sides of the body, coming up the middle, making Lawson be responsible for every single angle of every punch.
Most of the knockouts for Bizier has come earlier in his rounds. But here he's still showing great power in this middle part of the fight. With that knockdown in round five, we go to six, scheduled for 12. Jake Donovan, how are you scoring this?
All right, through four rounds, it was the closest 40-36 fight ever that Bizier broke it open in round five with the knockdown. I have Bizier up 50-44. The general has some work to do. He needs to march back.
Well said as he tries to do it here. Best work so far for Lawson. Lawson with good combinations and getting Ray some of those body shots in there you've been waiting for.
It's a thing of beauty. It's a lost art. Very seldom do you see fighters go to the body.
And I agree with Jake, Kenny. It's the closest 40-36 through the first four rounds. I mean, a lot of competitive close rounds, but the general simply wasn't doing enough to get the round. You can't give a guy a round for doing better. He's still got to win the round. And I love in the middle stages of this fight, rounds 5, 6, 7, both guys still digging in there with real intent to the body. It's just, it's good stuff, Ray.
Yes, I mean, with such conviction. I mean, he's really, really, they really drilled and take advantage of that shot.
Really putting money in the bank for the later rounds in a 12-round fight. You can't even begin to explain how imperative and important it is over 36 minutes, how much effect those body shots can have on one fighter.
But watch both. I mean, both of these guys are landing some good shots to the body.
And getting to the midway point in this fight, Ray, I'm curious to see what the corner of Lawson is telling him now. Hey, we got to make an adjustment. We got to do something a little different. He started this round better, but he still, you know, could lose this round and potentially be down 6-0.
And Bizier with the left. Bizier has been fighting at this pace since the start of the fight, and maybe that is a surprise, not that he would come and be right at him and on him, but that he would continue to do so.
If you expect to fight Bizier, you better be ready, that be in shape, and ready for some punches.
Beautiful body shot. And I think the mistake of Lawson is waiting for Bizier to get too close to him and get into those close quarters. He needs to punish him on his way in and not just let him get there and get off first. Lawson's his hands are locked a little too much. He's not letting his hands go.
Final seconds, reaching the halfway mark of this fight. Bizier continues to be the busy fighter on the undefeated Fredrick Lawson.
Back in Florida, the PBC on NBCSN alongside veteran trainer Barry Hunter. Barry, we've been watching this fight together. What has impressed you the most about Kevin Bizier of Canada?
Todd, Bizier has been busier. And I really, really love the pressure that he's applying to Lawson. And the smartest thing he has done tonight was invest in the body early. This man will have to find a way to gain respect in that ring and stop him from marching in like that.
And if you're Abel Sanchez working with Fredrick Lawson, what do you need your fighter to do in these next few rounds?
You need to double, triple the jab and find a way to go forward instead of reverse.
All right, that's the take from Barry Hunter. Back to Kenny.
All right, thank you, Todd. As we get underway here, in round 7, scheduled for 12, Bizier has been past the 8th round 3 times, and Lawson as well. Bizier getting that last round unofficially from Jake Donovan. It has been Bizier's fight. You figure he's ahead on points. But again, we saw a controversial majority draw earlier tonight, so we never assume anything.
No, I'm going to go on the record and say that there's no way Lawson's winning this fight unless he goes and makes a major, major change. He's got to let his hands go. And like Barry said, he's got to hit him on the way in and start to march forward and not let the momentum of Bizier control this entire fight.
Well, Bizier's been dominating this fight from the very first round. He knew his plan, and he stuck to it, and he's maintaining.
Well, in Bizier talks about having the stamina to go the distance. Lawson has been putting in more time in the ring in his last fights than he usually does. And his corner, Abel Sanchez, telling us at the fighter meeting yesterday, he was glad his guy was getting more work. He said, Freddie needs a little more work in the ring. He's getting a lot of work right now.
A little more than he bargained for, Kenny. We talked about levels of opposition. We talked about who has he fought compared to Bizier. Bizier's got the 2 losses, but to JoJo Dan, a very good fighter, you know, and Lawson's been fighting Bradis Prescott and Ray Nahr, guys like that that haven't gotten him ready for a guy like Kevin Bizier.
And Bizier continues to swing away. Not so much he's doing that, but Ray, his pace has slowed maybe that much since round 1.
A little less. Bizier, he hasn't stopped. I mean, he's been, his momentum, he picks it up. His tempo, his punches, his volume of punches, he's doing everything right. He's maintained.
And Bizier with a good left that digs into the body of Lawson.
Nice right hand by Lawson a second ago to buy him some space, but he wasn't able to get a combination once he got that space, and that's where he's lacking tonight, Kenny.
Oh, Lawson also needs to, he needs to put some fear into BZA's face. You know, make him think about coming in twice, but I think it's almost too late.
I think he can still do it, Ray, but he's got to do it now. You know, they're in round 7 now, so he's got to make a move.
Well, he has to stop moving. He won't get power moving like that.
Bizier hasn't blinked.
That left jab right there by Lawson could be a key punch in these last six rounds if he wants to get back in this fight.
A jab that's been absent for a long time.
Non-existent.
Final seconds, round seven. Bizier and Lawson still going at it. Lawson trying to pick it up late. Chris Algieri is in the house watching tonight. You see his mark 20-2. And then a man who came by to say hi to Ray and BJ earlier, Lamon Brewster. Best known for?
His knockout over Vladimir Klitschko at Mandalay Bay.
Exactly.
In Las Vegas.
A shot heard around the world there. Now we get back to this action. It's Bizier in the blue and red. He's been controlling the pace on the previously unbeaten here, Fredrick Lawson, gentlemen.
Yeah, really taking control, good combinations from the last round, and just really doing the same strategy throughout the entire fight, Kenny. It's been effective.
Great combination.
We go into round eight. Maybe that the fight still in the eighth round moving on is not a surprise, but that Bizier would continue to control the pace perhaps is. Lawson getting that last round, a round he needed unofficially by our score, Jake Donovan.
Good right hand by Lawson a second ago. He caught Bizier walking in, and that's what he's got to do. He can't just sit in front of him and wait.
And now he's using the jab more, Ray.
Yes, he is. But Bizier, I tell you, he's in incredible shape to maintain this tempo, this pace from the very first round. I mean, this is nothing new. He's been doing this from the round one to now.
And with Lawson, with those 20 knockouts on his impressive resume, he has no knockouts past the seventh round.
He's going to have to dig deep tonight, Kenny, and really find something within himself. But I like how he started this eighth round. He's boxed, he's moving, he's landing the shot, giving himself space, and firing another combination instead of waiting for Bizier to walk to him.
But here comes Bizier again. He certainly hasn't been hard for Lawson to find tonight.
Absolutely not.
He's right in front of him. Good left hook by Bizier.
Good left again by Bizier. Bizier scoring the only knockdown in this fight.
That left hook continues to get there. He's sneaking it. Very smart. Lawson's got his right hand up, but Bizier is able to sneak that punch behind his guard and then dig those body shots just to confuse
him. Bizier again with that left.
I can't say enough about Bizier and his body shots. It's just a thing of beauty.
Well, he's being very intelligent and very cerebral with his punch selection, Ray. He's digging certain spots. He's not just hitting you in the body. He's digging behind your right elbow. He's digging up the middle to the solar plex. He's digging behind the gloves on the right ear. He's very selective and smart.
Very selective with his punches.
And again, a couple of left hooks in there for Bizier. And Lawson just cannot seem to find a rhythm.
And it's not like Lawson hasn't had his moments, Kenny. He's shown some glimpses of, of being a real promising fighter, but Bizier just simply hasn't allowed him to get in the fight.
Well, we know Lawson has power again. He hasn't knocked anyone out past the seventh round, but he's knocked 20 out of 24 opponents out. And here's Bizier charging right back and avoiding the jab as well. Now Lawson able to get inside more.
And Lawson's got the right idea, Kenny. He's trying to box, he's trying to move now, but it's just too much from Bizier, and he really hasn't seen this type of opposition yet, so it's a very new experience for Lawson.
Final seconds. Again, Bizier impressive late in this fight. Final seconds, round eight in the books. Friday, November 20th, World Series of Fighting returns to NBCSN. Luis Palomino anchors an eight-man lightweight tournament. Winner gets to fight for the belt. World Series of Fighting Friday, November 20th on NBCSN. Okay. And there you see the corner of Kevin Bizier. And Mark Ramsey, his trainer. And here's Bizier in action, and he has been in action throughout this fight.
The left hook has been the key punch tonight, Kenny, along with the couple of the body attack. He's been relentless getting to the body of Lawson and really follows every combination with the left hook and has really punished Lawson with that punch.
Ray, we were talking earlier that Bizier got away from his game plan in the split decision loss to JoJo Dan. He said he did not intend to do it this time, and so far he hasn't.
He is right on time here. Aggressive from the very beginning, the very first round, picked up the tempo, throw some beautiful combinations, in control, totally in control.
And Jake has all rounds but one going to Bizier.
And if you look at the fight, you wouldn't think, man, how is the fight possibly scored that way? But to be honest, you've got to, you know, land the cleaner punches, and Bizier has been doing that all night, so it makes sense.
Let's check in with Todd Harris.
Here with Mark Ramsey. Mark, is there any question in your mind of Kevin's cardio and fitness? Can he go the distance, continuing with the pace that he's got?
No, this is something that we prepare in the training camp. We know going to that fight that Kevin's going to have to put pressure for 12 rounds, not only for 6 or 7 rounds, and this is something we work on.
During that last break, how did Kevin tell you? How is he feeling?
He's feeling good. He took a round that he going out a little bit of strategy, but now with the last round, he's back to the philosophy we want for that fight.
Thank you, Mark.
And Bizier, a 7-month layoff. He told us yesterday he thought that made him a fresher fighter. Lawson, meanwhile, a 7.5-month layoff. And it still looks like Bizier is at the pace, or close to it at least, that we saw earlier in this fight, Ray.
Well, you know what I tell you? I have to say, I'm so impressed with what I see in Bizier. I mean, good right hand right there.
I mean, Ray, that's been a key punch for him the last four rounds. He dug that left hook in there so many times early. He's now able to sneak the right hand in. And, you know, I want to make a suggestion about Bizier. He's done a great job against Lawson, but he's in a star-studded division. He's got Kell Brook. He's got Keith Thurman. He's got Sean Porter, those kind of types of names in his division. So it's not an easy road ahead.
This is an eliminator, and Kell Brook could be next in line for the winner of this fight.
I just don't know if this type of style is as good as it's been tonight, if this type of style matches up well with a guy like Kell Brook, so it's going to be very interesting when that fight happens. You can't stand in front of a puncher like Kell Brook.
It'd be a big step up.
Some thought he would not be able to stand this long in front of Lawson, not comparing him to Kell Brook, but Lawson coming in here with 20 knockouts and showing power of his own. But it's been Bizier who got the only knockdown. And it's been Bizier, Ray, who showed the composure that he said he lost in the Dan fight. Said, I won't lose it tonight, and so far he hasn't.
He has not lost it. Total composure.
And so they will fight on into round 10, Bizier and Lawson.
And in the pre-fight deal with both fighters, we talked about, you know, Bizier doesn't do anything great, but he does a lot of things very good. Combination punching, he's controlled this entire fight, guys. Sunk that right hand in behind the guard, dug the left hook to the body, and then that's how he set up the knockdown with that sneaky right hand. But he's been very consistent throughout the fight and just able to really punish Lawson every single round of this fight so far, and he's got a lot of good work done, guys.
And Ray, we talked about Bizier being that very solid basic fighter, but he's done a little bit more than that tonight. I think he's been a little more of an intimidating fighter perhaps than people thought he would be.
He's just relentless. I think Bizier is just on the attack and takes control, takes advantage of it. I mean, it's a great performance by Bizier.
Live here in the 10th, it's Bizier in the blue and white, the Canadian making his U.S. debut. 24-2, both losses to one man, Jojo Dan, both those by way of split decision. And here he is fighting past the eighth round for the third time. You see the unofficial scoring from Jake Donovan, including that 10-8 round, the fifth round, where Bizier knocked Lawson down.
And I like the mentality that Bizier has came in with the fight with Kenny. You know, he, like I said, he's very consistent. He's very strong. He doesn't do anything great, but he's been a bully tonight. He just came right in and said, Lawson, I don't care what you want to do. We're doing this thing, and we're doing this fight my way.
And to really appreciate the condition of Bizier, the fact that this is a tenth round, and he's still throwing combinations.
Still is, still moving forward, and Lawson does not have an answer.
And Lawson's a very, very tough man to stand in there and take the body shots and the hooks. You know, the overhand rights, everything he has, like Bizier has dished out. So a lot of credit and kudos to him for that. He's still trying to win in there. It's just not working out for him tonight.
But do you notice every time he finished the punch, the last punch is to the body? When he gets close enough.
And you just got to attribute that to great fundamentals and technique that Bizier's father taught him on the Canadian national team, and then also in the corner with Mark Ramsey.
His dad, a well-respected amateur coach there, brought him to Ramsey, said, I want you to take over as a pro. And he's brought him this far, brought him into this eliminator in the welterweight ranks. with Brooks as Brooke as a possibility for the winner.
Mark Ramsey has done an incredible job with Bizier.
He wouldn't tell us about the strategy. They were playing it very close to the vest of the fighter meetings yesterday. As a matter of fact, Bizier, who is bilingual, was talking in French most of the time, and Mark was translating, and possibly so that he wouldn't give much away. He didn't want his fighter to tell us too much. Said they had a game plan. I don't know if anyone thought it'd be a game plan that I'm going to stand in front of Lawson, a knockout specialist, and take the fight to him like I am right now.
Well, this is the game plan. So this they could have disclosed that, because the opponent has to weather the storm.
I don't know if any of us would have believed that he would continue this pace for 10 rounds right in his face like he has. You think? Bizier looking good. As we get ready to move on to the 11th round. There is Fredrick Lawson. He has yet to lose in 24 fights, most of those coming in his home country of Ghana. This is his fourth fight in the U.S. Let's listen in. He and Abel Sanchez and BJ will interpret.
You not okay? What's the matter with you? Talk to me.
How are we doing over here?
I'm doing okay.
Okay?
Yes. What's the matter? Talk to me.
My jaw.
Your jaw?
Okay, we heard that now. His jaw.
That's it.
It's over.
That might be it.
David, I'm not sure how I called that, but
you heard Abel Sanchez talk about the jaw, and that's it. That is it. Fredrick Lawson is not coming out to answer the bell.
The right side of the jaw, Kenny, from those left hooks repetitively throughout the fight. He dug him into the body, made Lawson very susceptible. And, you know, it just looked like at the end of that round that there was, a lot of questions going on in the mind of Lawson. And Abel Sanchez did the right thing, in my opinion.
Kevin Bizier has won by way of TKO in a fight that he had been dominating throughout. And Abel, in any language, it could be Spanish, English, any language, you could tell that he was ready to say enough. My fighter has had enough tonight.
Well, the body language of Lawson just showed that he was a beaten fighter, and at this point, Abel Sanchez made the right decision that, you know, it's not my guy's day. I'm gonna save him and bring him back another time to fight another day.
Very smart, BJ.
Hall of Fame ref Steve Smoger, what about the stoppage, the decision in the corner of Sanchez with his fighter Lawson?
Dr. Gordon advised that the jaw may be broken or severely damaged and ordered the referee to stop the fight.
And there was no hesitation in the corner as you look at Fredrick Lawson with his first loss, and there's the celebratory corner of Kevin and his company all gathered around him. And coming into this, Bizier, first fight in the U.S., he said, I'm ready to show everybody, because he hadn't even fought out of his province, much less his home country.
But what did that mean tonight, Kenny? Kevin Bizier wrote a story of resilience. He lost twice to JoJo Dan. He thought his career was over. And now, look, he's back winning an eliminator, going to go into another title fight with Kell Brook. And he's feeling on top of the world right now, I guarantee.
And let's take a look at the end of the last round. Maybe this is where the damage was done.
Just more of the same from Bizier, Kenny.
And now let's listen to the corner.
What's the matter? Talk to me.
My jaw.
Your jaw? That's it.
Stopping the fight?
Yeah, he's got his, I think he broke
Stopping
his jaw.
Stopping the fight?
I think he broke his jaw.
And Abel Sanchez, the trainer, no hesitation. For the young Freddie Lawson coming in here, was 24-0. Kevin Bizier goes to 25-2, 17 wins by way of knockout now as he picks up the TKO victory here. And it now is Bizier who has put himself in position to get the title shot at welterweight world champ Kell Brook. When we come back, we'll hear from Kevin Bizier. He came to the U.S. and has his hands raised with an impressive win.
Ladies and gentlemen, the official time, 2 minutes 59 seconds into round number 10. The winner by TKO, Kevin Bizier.